reality, though, we don't know that they get paid jack squat. So how can we have these people who consider basically part of the middle class but work the class to turn against the 1% of the government and fight for the people who actually care?
Well, that's a good question. I mean, not just the police, but also people in the military. Because there's an economic incentive also going to the military. I was going to be drafted, for example, but I joined, because at that time in 1972, if you joined the military, then you could control your destiny to a certain extent. Instead of being shipped off to Vietnam, you join for 3 years, as opposed to being drafted for 2 years, and then you can determine what kind of job you had and where you were placed. But then I re-enlisted in the military, even though I was catching hell. Why? Because when it was time for you to come out, either at the height of the 1973-1975 recession in the U.S., and I had a wife and two kids. So there was a material incentive for me to stay in the military. Many people going into the military now, they're not going in because of, like, they're going in because they need a job. Okay? And so what we do and what we did in the past was, we tried to engage folks in the military, we tried to politicize folks, and we need to do that again. I met one because of my particular experiences to tell people don't go in the military, especially when you have really very few options. But I will tell people, don't engage in any legal wars. Don't allow them to make you into a war criminal. So we were very clear. There were certain, we knew what we were going to do in that particular military, 1972, 73, 74, 75. There were certain things we weren't going to do. In fact, we didn't do it. We opposed, we had sit down strikes and all kinds of stuff. But the military today is a lot different than it was in those days. Some people think for the better, perhaps. Well, I don't want to, you all stuck in and really fantastic questions and comments. I really have enjoyed this. I'm really impressed with the student body here at Truman. And it's really interesting. I hope you all continue these kinds of conversations, these kinds of struggles. Recognizing that, none of us have the answers. But being open to the debates, being open to the struggles, recognizing if there's contradictions in your positions, that you might need to alter those. And if you approach the struggles in that way, I think we're going to be all right. We're going to have more people ready to take up the historic work of transforming this society, transforming.
Thank you. Thank you again, John, for your time, your programs, and your openness in your talk and discussion. For those who are interested in continuing to talk about these topics or organizing on campus, SDS meets at 7 p.m. tomorrow, every Thursday in 210. Some of our upcoming events that you might be interested in, we're having a budget town hall where we will be discussing the budget crisis at Truman State University on February 24th at 2 p.m. You're all invited. And then on March 5th, we'll be having the Socialist Party USA presidential candidate, Mimi Soltysik, here to speak. On March 22nd, we'll have Eric K. Olson, a Marxist economist from UMKC, here to talk to us. And on April 12th, we're going to have Mike Beal, who is a union worker and a union organizer in St. Joseph, Missouri. He'll be talking to us about right to work. So thank you again for all coming out, and thank you.
Thank you.